There are so many questions about this individual throttle body EFI on this Hot Rod 911. So I thought I would just take it one by one and do a short format video and answer the questions the best I can. So this one's gonna be about the fuel system, the return style, the location of the fuel pressure regulator, and why I did it the way I did it. Some people are asking why there's plumbing on both sides of the fuel rail. There's plumbing here, and there's also plumbing back there. My choice was to go with more of the OEM style fuel system, which puts the fuel pressure regulator after the fuel rails or after the throttle bodies. You can run the fuel pressure regulator before the fuel rails, and it simplifies the plumbing somewhat. But the reason why I didn't do that, it's because the fuel pressure regulator is a restriction. In fact, that's how it works. It's basically a spring with a plunger inside. To get the fuel pressure you need for a fuel injection, which is about 45 PSI in this engine, you have to restrict the flow. And if you put it before the fuel injectors, that means that in peak fuel demand, you not only have to pump fuel through the fuel filter, but you also have to pump it through the fuel pressure regulator. The pressure drop across the fuel pressure regulator can be significant, probably more so than the fuel filter. It can slow the fuel flow down when you need it the most. So if you put the fuel pressure regulator behind the fuel injectors, now the path to the fuel injectors is unrestricted. The bulk of the fuel flow is going right into the injectors, and the only amount of fuel that's returned is the excess fuel that the pump created, and that restriction is done on the return side. Now, it's certainly possible to maintain a fuel pressure in the fuel rail by controlling how much fuel goes back to the tank. So the fuel comes in from the supply, that goes right from the tank. There is a filter underneath the car. It goes into this T-junction and it splits almost even distance to the banks, left and right. So a part of it goes to this bank 1, 2, 3, and the other part of it goes via this hard line into this fuel rail, which is 4, 5, 6. So after the fuel fills this fuel rail, which has a pretty big volume inside, it then gets diverted via these hard lines out to the side. So it's coming out of here, it's going up into the fuel pressure regulator, which I have mounted here on the side. So there's dual inlets for the fuel pressure regulator. And then what is extra fuel that can't be consumed by the engine is then returned via this line, which kind of snakes up and down into that return. My fuel pump is a standard Walbro intake fuel pump. It runs at a constant 12 volts.